Should we blame Alstom for this? I mean, GE bought their energy business 2015 and it's gone south.
Alstom is a big part of it. It was not the best timing for that deal. The gas power market has really been struggling lately. And when they announced Alstom, that was in early 2014. It took over a year and a half for them to close that deal. And by that point, they added tens of thousands of new workers and really expanded that business at just about the worst possible time.
Is it a case that they just didn't transition enough? Is this another, I don't want to say Kodak, but, obviously there are some, maybe there's a string to be drawn between the two in the sense that we're headed towards a renewables world and GE is still in the old technology business.
Yeah, they're dealing with this now. They actually do have a renewable energy business, and so they're trying to build that up. And in fact, some of it came from Alstom. So in that way, the deal actually will benefit them. But it's not necessarily a net positive or even neutral for GE if they do transition to renewables because they don't have as strong a position in that market. They do have a good position in wind energy, but they're not the undisputed number one the way they are in gas turbines. And then also they can be less profitable because the aftermarket maintenance work isn't necessarily as lucrative as it is for a gas turbine.
Rick, GE, the worst performer on the Dow this year, but number one when it comes to cutting jobs. This will not sit well with President Trump.
No, it probably won't. I think GE has other concerns right now. They're probably looking at Trump's tweets, and he hasn't said anything about them yet. But
they're saying that they're going to cut those jobs overseas, so that might help.
That might help. And they haven't specified the exact breakdown, but as I reported earlier, that most of the cuts are likely to come outside the U.S. So that'll help. But really, they don't have much choice here. They need to cut costs. Yeah.